Good morning, children. How are you? I hope you are fine and you are safe. So please stay at home and be healthy and be safe. Okay, children? So yesterday we have completed till here. Okay. So now we are going to learn about this. Already we have completed in the video which showing the all the parts of the seed. Okay. Experiment 1. Soak some gram seeds in water. What are these, children? Gram seeds. Okay. Water for a couple of days. Couple of days means 2 days or 3 days. Okay. Take one of these seeds. You will notice that it has an outer covering which has swelled because the seed was in water. This outer covering is called is the seed coat. Okay. So whenever you are soaking the grams into the water, you can find that the seed is somewhat swell. Okay. And that swollen part, when you are seeing that one, and you know that is very wet in nature. Okay. So the outer part of that seed is called as seed coat. What this outer part is called as seed coat. Okay. These are cotyledons. Cotyledons also called as seed leaves. The gram has 2 seed leaves, means 2 cotyledons. That's the reason it is called as dicot. What is this called as? Dicot seed. Okay. This I told you on that day. This is a tiny shoot. It is growing into the above the ground, and this is tiny root. This is growing under the ground. Okay. Remove the seed coat. You will see 2 seed leaves or cotyledons. So seed leaves are also called as cotyledons. Separate them and you find a baby plant inside. On that day we have seen in that video, right? But a small plant was there. Yes, this baby plant has a tiny shoot and tiny root, as we see in the picture. Next, food for the baby plant is stored in the seed leaves. As long as the baby plant does not grow green leaves, it depends on the food stored in the seed. Seeds of some plants like grams, peas, beans have 2 seed leaves and they are called as dicot seeds. See, few plants have seeds of 2 seed leaves. If you are just keeping in the water and then you are removing out, you can find it two seed leaves. They are called as 2 cotyledons. So they are called as 2 seed leaves. Okay, children? Yes. And some seeds of some plants like wheat, maize and rice have 1 seed leaf and they are called as monocot seeds. So you can see this maize seed. Maize seed has only 1 leaf, and that's why it is called as monocot. Like wheat, rice are monocot seeds. But like green gram, Bengal gram and brown gram, these have a 2 seed leaves. That is the reason they are called as dicot seeds. Now let us see the germination. See, germination, the development of a seed into a seedling is called as germination. From the seed to seedling, the development of seed to seedling and to the plant, that is called as germination. Okay, let us do an experiment to find out the conditions necessary for the germination of seed. Experiment 2. We have seen all these experiments. Let us just check a glance. Okay. Take 4 plates and number them as 1, 2, 3 and 4. Take some dry gram seeds. You have to take what, children? Dry gram seeds. What is dry gram seeds? This one you can find as chana or chanaga. You are saying, no, that one. Okay. Put some seeds in plate number 1. So how many plates you have to take, children? 4 plates. In the plate number 1, what we have to do? We have to keep a dry seeds only. And keep the plate on a windowsill. On the day I told you, nearby window, that is called as windowsill. What is it called as, children? Windowsill. Where it can get air and sunlight. Put some seeds in plate 2. Okay. Now what you have to take? You have to take the plate 2. For the first plate, you have to keep in the windowsill and it has to keep under the sunlight so that it can air get some water and air and sunlight. Okay, now next one. Plate 2. Put the plate inside beaker containing water. Now place the beaker on the windowsill. Put some seeds soaked on moist cotton wool in plate 3. So in the plate too, what you have to say? See, here you have to take one plate. In that one few Bengal grams you have to take, and then you keep in the beaker. Okay, this is plate two. Okay, it is totally immersed in water. Okay, children, next. And that this beaker you have, where you have to keep? In the room, in the corner? No, you have to keep in the near the windowsill. Windowsill, I told you, no, near by the window. Keep the plate inside the refrigerator. Put some seeds soaked into the moist cotton. Now here plate 3. Okay, soak seeds kept inside the refrigerator. So here, check once. Put some soaked seeds on a moist cotton wool in a plate 3. In the plate 3, what you need to do is you have to take some cotton. You have to moist cotton, like you have to take dipped in the water, and you have to keep that one in the refrigerator. Okay. And fourth plate, you have to take in the cotton wool only. Put some seeds soaked on moist wool in the plate 4. Place some plate on the windowsill. Keep the cotton wool of plate 4 moist all the time. Okay. So this one plate 4 you have to keep all the time moist, when it should not dry. Okay, see, this plate is already is there in the cotton, and you have to keep in the refrigerator, and this one is in the wool. Okay, now let us see what are, so seeds are kept in the different condition, what will happen to the seeds, we will check. Okay, now fill in the blanks, please write this, children. Okay, now fill in the table. Okay, condition the seed got air, warmth and the sunlight. Condition the seed didn't get. Here the plate 1 air it got, warmth it got, sunlight also it got. What is not getting? Moisture. And so see, the did the seed germinate? No. Here moisture is there, water is there, warmth is there. What is not there, beta? Sunlight. So sunlight is not there. So without the sunlight it can grow? No. Here only air and moisture is there. Where, what about the warmth? What about the sunlight? Nothing is there. Only two things are then. Then how can it can grow? Yes. No, na? So it is also no. But in the plate 4, air is there, moisture is there, warmth is there. Three of the things are there. What are the things? Nothing. Here? Yes. Yes, it can, with the seeds can germinate. Okay, children? Now, here. Here. You will notice that only the seeds, plate 4, have germinated. This shows that air, moisture, water and warmth, sunlight are the necessary conditions for germination. Here warmth is for sunlight, na? Here what is not there also, beta? Air is also not there, beta. Okay, air we can strike the sunlight also, but because of warmth is there. But what is not there actually? Here air is not there, and here air, moisture, warmth, three of the things are there. Okay, warmth nothing but sunlight only. Warmth is nothing but sunlight only, so it won't germinate. Okay, next. Are the necessary conditions for the germination. What are the necessary conditions? Air, moisture, warmth. Moisture means water, warmth means sunlight. Okay. This is because germinating seed needs air to breathe. Water makes the seed coat, soft. This helps the baby plant to break the seed open and come out. Warmth is needed for the cells of the seed to become active. Okay, so what are the uses for, like, suppose air is not there, then they can't breathe. Water is not there, the seed coat can't be solid, it will be hard only. Okay, as dry as that previous one. And if the warmth is not there, then sunlight is not there, it is not become active. Okay, now what is the process of germination? Experiment 3. Take some germinating seeds in plate 4, like experiment 2 only. Put them on a piece of wet net cloth tied over the mouth of the jar. As you see in the picture, you have to take our seeds and which are germinated, and at the brim of the end, tied with the thread or the cloth or anything. But here you have to take the wet cloth only, wet net cloth. It should be wet, it should be netted cloth. Okay, in the mouth of the jar. So how the process of germination develops? Small plant will be growing on here, and here the shoot and root will be growing on. Here the root will be growing. Here the shoot will be growing on. This is the process of germination. So here the gravity also plays an important part, because the roots can growing down only and the shoots can growing up only. Okay, children. Next, tiny roots will come out of the soft and moist seed coats. Later the shoots too will come out. The root grows downward towards gravity and the shoot grows upward towards the sunlight. These seedling grows and becomes a plant. Okay, children. So how much you have understand? Like this one I have already told you, now from the picture. So here what the shoot is growing at, it is towards the sunlight and it is growing to the gravity. Okay, so how the seed is developing into a plant, this because of the germination process. Okay, children, you can write this one in your book. Okay, now our next topic is dispersal of seeds. Okay, dispersal means scattering of seeds. Okay, a plant produces so many seeds. Plants are fixed to the ground and cannot move from one place to another. So if all seeds fall and germinate near the mother plant, they would not get enough sunlight, food and water and space to grow. Because of this, many seedlings would not survive. Hence, there are some agents in nature to scatter these seeds. The process of scattering of seeds or fruits away from their parent plant is called as dispersal of seeds. You can just underline from here to here, children. Okay, so what do you mean, understand by this paragraph, children? See, plant has more parts, like fruits are there, and from if the fruits are fallen down from the ground, it will be all the seeds are growing into a new plant. No, they can be taken from one place to another by the other agents. Okay, so that process of scattering of seeds or fruits from one place to another, because that parent plant, because it is growing far from the parent plant, that is the reason the dispersal of seeds are helping in the environment to grow more plants. Okay, so if they are getting all the favorable conditions like warmth, air, moisture, sunlight, everything, then only a seed is developed into a plant, otherwise it won't develop into the plant. What do you mean by dispersal of seeds? Is a process, the process of scattering of seeds or fruits away from their plant is called dispersal of seeds. Okay, children, let us, what are the different types of dispersal, agents of dispersal? Dispersal is carried out by wind, water, animals and by the explosion of fruits. These are called agents of dispersal. The special structures of certain seeds and fruits help these seeds in dispersal. Okay, so there are different agents of dispersal. Air, water and explosion of fruits and animals. Okay, so we have seen one by one all the things. Yes, we have seen the examples also. Let us see more. Okay, seeds of cotton mather and hiptage are light, very light. They have hair or wings, so they can be easily carried by the wind. The lotus fruit has spongy part and the coconut has fibrous outer covering to enable them float on water. Okay, here you can see, children, here the porous plants of the lotus is there. Here it can fill the water and it can blow away from one place to another in a water. And here the fibrous part is there of the coconut. Seeds are present and which can flow into the water from one place to another and it can grow into a new plant. Okay, children, next. Human beings and animals eat fruits like cherries and mangoes and throw away their seeds. Some seeds have hooks, spines or stiff hair. They get stuck into the furry skin of animals, feathers of birds or even to our clothes and are thus carried away. Birds often swallow some seeds which come out unchanged in their droppings. Okay, children, what they are trying to say is, like most of the human beings and animals, we are eating the mangoes and we are eating the cherries. Most of them, we are eating the fruits and we are just eating the pulp of their fruits. And then we are throw away the seeds. And from that seeds, they are growing into a new plants. Okay. Sometimes some seeds have hooks also. They are like a thorny nature. Okay, and they can stick the fur of the animals like dogs and cats, and then like feathers of birds also. And they can scatter from one place to another. And if the conditions are favorable, they are growing into a new plants. Okay. Even sometimes what happened, the birds like hen and crow, what happened, they swallow the seeds and they are growing, they are just traveling from one place to another, and they, in their droppings as it is, they are not digested in their bodies and they are just come out in their droppings. And if the conditions are favorable, then it growing into a new plant. Okay, so here, some fruits like peas in a pot burst open or explode when dry. The force of explosion helps to shatter the seeds. Okay, so one more agent is, that is explosion. Like here you can see this pea pot burst open. Okay, it growing, it is growing, and again what happened, one day it is burst with explosion, and then it gives away all the seeds, and that seeds are growing into a new plant. Okay. See here, the xanthium seed is present. Huh? Xanthium seed has stiff hair, it's stuck into your clothes and socks and all. Okay, and this pear gas, it is stuck into your different cloths or fur. Okay, and hooks, they have hooks. The tiger nail seed has hooks also. Okay, so we have see this diagram. This is cotton seed which have hair. This you have seen a lot of times, right? The seed is outside and it is stuffed off air. And hiptase hair as wing. Maybe you have basically these medar seeds. Okay. Moreover, the dandelion seeds are there. Okay. The same manner they are dispersed by the wind. So these are the dispersed by the wind examples. These are the seed dispersed by the water like lotus and coconut. These are the dispersed by the animals, and these are the explosion. So we have completed till here the dispersal. If you are getting any of the doubts, please free to ask children. And tomorrow we have completed here, and tomorrow we are going to complete this. Okay children, I hope you have understand and you have learnt a new things, and I hope you are fine, and take care children. Bye bye.